Hello everyone, it's Darby Riverbend Survival again. First things first, if it looks like I'm sitting really low at my table, it's because I am. I guess somebody in my house decided they want the chair off my desk more than I needed it. So I'm sitting on a little camp stool. I'll raise hell about that later. The reason for this video though is, the mailman came knocking today. As most if not all of you know, a bunch of us just met up in Tennessee about 2 weeks ago for the bushcraft meetup. And the best part about the bushcraft meetup, the view's nice, the camping's awesome, the facilities are great. The absolute best part about it is the people that you meet, the people that become friends. I met a man up there named Tom. We were talking, actually he was talking to somebody else, and I noticed that he had a knife sheath on his side, and that he was carrying the Becker BK2 Companion, one of these. I have one. I love the knife. I hate the sheath with a passion. I've already done the mods to it and stuff. It's just not a good sheath. I don't know why Becker doesn't fix it. It's the number one complaint. You look up this knife online, people are going to say, love the knife, hate the sheath. Love the knife, hate the sheath. That's all you hear nonstop. I don't know why they don't fix it. There are some companies out there and some people that make sheaths for them that are so nice that, A, the knife isn't as nice as the sheath is. And B, I'm not going to go out and spend $150, $200 to put a $60 or $70 knife in. Doesn't make any sense to me. So, to make this long story shorter, I pretty much quit carrying it. I just hate the sheath so much, even with the doing the mods to it, which made it better, I just hate this sheath. So I quit carrying it. I saw Tom, and he was wearing one, and he had a nice leather sheath. So I asked him, hey buddy, where'd you get the sheath from? He said he made them. We get to talking, and he said that he was going to send me one for my knife. I told him I would look at it, and if I liked it, I would do a video on it. You know, I don't endorse things, I don't sell things. But when a friend's doing something like that, especially an unboxing, unboxing videos are always an exception to that. But when a friend makes something, I think it's worthwhile to let other people know about it if it's a good product. I've already seen his. I know it's a good product. That's why I was so excited to get this box. He since wrote me an email, or two or three, but he said he was going to send some other stuff. Obviously, this box is too big to hold a sheath for this knife. So let's open it up and see what he sent. Hopefully I'm not cutting anything inside of it. Oh, there's a bunch of stuff in here. Look at this leather pouch. It's like a what I would use for a tender pouch. Very soft, very nice leather. This is really nice. There's another pouch inside of it. Oh, it's a belt pouch. Made out of almost like a suede-like material. That's nice. You know what that'd be great for is going out and collecting. Collecting berries, things like that. Just put this on your belt and go. That'd be very nice for that. This is gorgeous. I've been in cars that don't have that nice leather in them. This is a Go Cup. Oh, that's pretty cool. It's one of those pop-up cups I've seen people using. I like that a lot. Oh, it's got a compartment in the top of it. That's nice. I'll use that a lot. I'll go in my kit this afternoon. A Go Tubbs Civilized One-Handed Containers. Oh, those are nice. They're just little plastic storage containers. There's a set of three of them. That's got way too many uses to even start to think about what I'll use those for. But I got plenty of things. Y'all know I like little bags and pouches and stuff to keep my bags organized. That's nice. Lewis and Clark, Gear Up and Go. Oh, travel soap sheets. These are nice. These are handy. They're like a hand soap kind of deal. They come in a little plastic container. They dissolve in water, and you don't need to carry the liquid squirt stuff. You can just use one of these little towelette things. These are nice. I guess I'll have to call him and ask him why he's sending me a Go Girl. Girls don't... What does it say? Don't take life sitting down. Go Girl allows women the convenience of standing to urinate. It's clean, portable, discreet, and reusable. I guess I'll give this to my wife or one of my daughters. That's just funny. They'll probably find it useful. I find it funny. Here's the meat of the subject. Those are nice. I love those leather pouches. Oh, there's two sheets in here. Oh, you know what? He mentioned that these can be used, if you don't form them to the knife, that they're the same size that fits the Bakko Laplander. And I do have a Bakko Laplander. It's actually up at the land right now. Yeah, this is like the one he had. This is just great craftsmanship. Now, I need to explain. He told me, as best I understand it, if not, he'll correct in the comments on the video here. Excuse me. That he started getting into this leather working a couple of months ago and has decided that he wants to do this as a part-time hobby kind of thing, and that he will be taking orders for stuff. I do not have. I told him that I would recommend starting a YouTube page and a Facebook page for it. When I last chatted with him, he had not started it. I went and looked. So what I'll do is if I can get the information before this video goes up, I'll put a link on the video down here. If not, when I get the information, I'll update the video and put the information on it. This is just a good quality leather sheath. Nothing fancy, no bells and whistles. Great stitching on it, good sturdy leather. You can't ask for any more than this. This, I don't know how well it's showing up on there. This is just a good heavy duty leather sheath. But now here comes the real test. Oh, it fits like a glove. Fits like an absolute glove in there. And it's one of those that hangs down low off the belt. So it's not poking in your side or whatever. That'll never fall out. That is a great sheath. That's exactly what I wanted, and that's what he was wearing. So I knew what I was getting here. I did not know about this stuff, and I did not know about the second one. If I had, I would have gone up by the land. Well, I can't get to the land right now. It's flooded. I would have gone by the land. You know what I do use, though? I don't use the Bakko, as you know, or the people that watch my videos. I have nothing against the Bakko. It's a great saw. But what I like to use is, and I don't know if I have one here or not. Yep. I like to use these Lennox saws. They're aluminum. And you can get them at plumbing or electrical houses, probably get them at Lowe's or Home Depot. I love these things because they just use Sawzall blades. So I can throw an extra Sawzall blade or two in there if one breaks. I don't care, it takes seconds to change a blade. And I bet you this slips right in here. Like it was made for it. So that's absolutely perfect. I love the stuff. Make sure there's nothing else down in the box. Anyway, Thanks, Tom, for the stuff. I absolutely love it. Like I said, I was expecting this. We had talked about this. He had mentioned that these will work on a saw, so that doesn't surprise me. But all of this extra stuff, this is just crazy handy stuff to have. And it's stuff that, to be honest with you, I wouldn't normally buy for myself. That's why I like it so much, because this is just handy. You want to drink water, you want to do whatever with this. This is great. I love the leather pouches. Especially this one that's going to be a tender bag. I can tell you that now. The knife sheaths, great quality, great craftsmanship. The bags, great stuff. This is going to be handy as all get out. Just going out and picking up wild edibles, or actually, this is so nice. I could actually take this and just use it as a belt pouch. Just hook it on my belt and keep stuffing anything I wanted to in there. Really, you'll be seeing all of this in my videos coming up. All of this, everything here, with the exception of the Go Girl, will be added to my kits. So you'll be seeing those coming up. Anyway, like I said, if I can get the information before this video goes up tonight, I'll put it on this video. If not, when I get the information from him, I'll update the video and put the information. If you're looking for a good, sturdy, utilitarian, heavy-duty leather sheath for your Becker, your Campanion, I would give him a call. I don't know how many other kind of knives he's going to be doing, or if he's going to be doing other kinds. I don't even need to test this. I mean, it's leather. I can look at the quality of it, and I can look at the stitching, and I can look at the feel and the make of it, and I know he's already using them. So I don't need to do any kind of field test on this. This goes right into service, and this piece of junk goes in the junk drawer with the rest of the stuff that I never, ever use. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. I know I did. Remember, get out in the dirt and have some fun. Thanks.